Hey Fox, in this video we can take a look into Cloudera Manager update. So I have a cluster with 4 data nodes and 1 master, and which is hosted in Amazon AWS. And my cluster is running with CDH 5.102 and Cloudera Manager 5.100. So this is the version, Cloudera Enterprise Hub Edition Trial 5.1.0. So I'm going to upgrade this to 5.12.0. So for that, first thing I need to do is I need to create a repository, or I need to configure a repository. I'm using a manual local repository. So for that, go to archive.cloudera.com, then cm5 repo *, then select the version which you want. So 5.12.0. So this is the version which I'm going to install. So get the Cloudera Manager package which is matching with our operating system. So I'm using CentOS 6.0. So this is the matching one. So copy link location. Okay, so this is the one which I need to do. Then go to my master machine where I have created repo files. Okay, so wget and downloading this one 5.12.0. so again, it take some time, depends on the network bandwidth, but if you are using Amazon AWS, it will be much faster compared to your home network. So it take 1 or 2 minutes maximum. So I think it's near to the completion. Yeah, so that's it. So I have completed the downloading. Then unzip and keep it into my web server, tar zxvf this file -c /var/ww. okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm creating a new directory. Okay, so let me unzip here first, tar zxvf. Okay, so it's going to create a directory like this. So let me do this in another way, tar zxvf this file -c /var/ww/html. That's it. So take some time because it has to unzip and place that package under this location. So under this location, so it will create a new directory cm and keep all these files over there. So that's it. So unzip has completed. So if I go to this directory, and I can see one file with cm. So this is the directory. So earlier I have 5.1.0, so those files are there, and 5.1.2. So this is the new directory. Okay, so this is corresponding to new version. So I need to change my yum repo files, and so that it has to point to this location. So for example, cd this one, and under that, okay, so we have reported. So what I'm doing is, so I'm editing this file on each and every machine, etc yum.repos.d, then Cloudera Manager repo. Okay, so before editing this, you can take a backup of this file if needed. So I'm directly editing this one here. So replace that 5.1.0 with. So now I'm pointing to new version. So do the same thing across all the machine, etc yum.repos.d Cloudera, and under base URL, so it was pointing to 5.1.0, so now I have to point to 5.12.0. so I'm doing it across all the machines, including master and slave. Okay, I have modified this repo file across all the machine. Then after that, so I'm doing yum clean all, then yum make cache command. So these two commands, so I'm doing it across all the machines. Okay, so before, so now I have yum as updated, and before doing upgrade, so I need to turn off all the services. Okay, so Cloudera, whatever the CDH component, I'm just stopping. So, but you need to stop Cloudera Manager alone, but I'm doing the CDH also. Okay. Then I'm stopping all the Cloudera management services also. So that is stopped. Then, okay, so it's completely stopped. So let me do a logout from here. And so I need to stop Cloudera Manager master as well as the slave component, that is Cloudera Manager server and Cloudera Manager agents. So service Cloudera hyphen SSCM hyphen server stop. So service Cloudera hyphen SSCM hyphen agent stop. So the service I have to stop. So on this machine I need to stop this one. Here also I need to stop the agent service, and for the machine, yeah, so that's it. So I have stopped all the services. So while upgrading, so there may be chances like database corruption and all, so you need to be careful. Like so you need to take the proper backup of your database, so in case of any failure, so we can recover those backup. So we have to take the complete backup of the database where Cloudera Manager is using. Okay, since it's a lab based environment, I am not taking the backup at this time, but if you are doing in a production based environment, it's highly recommended to take the backup. So now I'm just checking what are the packages available and what are the packages I need to upgrade here. So this is my master machine. So in master I need to upgrade. So you can see the different versions. So 5.10 is here and 5.120 is here. So yum-y upgrade. So I need to upgrade. So JDK 1.7, the same version is there. So agent I need to upgrade because in master also I have agent. So daemon I need to upgrade because 5.120 is there. Then the server also I need to upgrade. That's it. So these are the components I need to upgrade. I think server DB, which I'm not using, and debug info, this is also not using. Okay, so I am upgrading all these components, and okay, so again it takes some time. So on all other nodes I need to upgrade agent components, so Cloudera Manager agent and daemons. So this one I am upgrading here, and this one, sorry. So let me copy it again from here. Think. Okay, so let better find it from here. Yum, list all. Grep Cloudera. Okay, so yum-y upgrade Cloudera Manager agent and the Cloudera Manager daemon. So this thing I need to do it across all the nodes. This one, this machine also need to do, and last machine also. Okay, so now we can come back to our master. So everything is done. So now we can start the services. Service Cloudera-SCM-Agent. Check the status. So it's stopped. Then start. Also SCM server. So this also we need to start. So do start agent across all the nodes. Also make sure this file is correct, I mean pointing to the correct master, etc Cloudera SCM agent, then config.ini. yes, there is no change. So let's start the service. Okay, so started agent here, the second one. Okay, so it's still running only. Yeah, so I'm just starting the agent here. Here it's completed. The last machine also started. So now I have started agent and master. So that's it about the upgrade. So we have to wait some time because the Cloudera server will take some time to initialize. So once we started, so we have to wait some time and open the browser and use the same URL again. Okay, so initially it takes some time because the Cloudera server initialization takes some time. So we'll wait some time and refresh this again. Okay, so now we got this console window. So use your credential admin. Okay, and now we have two options for upgrading agents. So one is the one which I have done, like do yum upgrade across all the nodes and do that. But if you have very lot of machines, then it will be a bit challenging. Then you have option, okay, so you have option to upgrade the agent by using Cloudera Manager. So or else, okay, I would like the agent upgrade now. So yes, I would upgrade that. Okay, so this is why, because I am doing, so I have already upgraded the agent across all the nodes. So if you want the Cloudera Manager to do that task instead of the one we have done, so this you have to select the first one, then continue. Okay, so Cloudera Management Service. Okay, so this is completed, then click finish. So now it's loading Cloudera Manager homepage. So you can see all the services are stopped, then you can start the service from here. Okay, so it will start entire services one by one. Meanwhile, okay, so let's minimize this. If you close this, it will run in background. Okay, so you can see still it is running in background. Okay, starting the service. And also you can check the version, whatever the version, whether it's upgraded properly. Yes, so it's showing as 5.12.0. So this is how we can upgrade the Cloudera Manager. Okay, so you can upgrade the Cloudera Manager agent and master server components by using yum upgrade command. Okay, so but we need to be very careful and make sure so we have a proper backup mechanism in place for this backend database. So now our cluster is almost healthy, so except some memory related warnings. So we have successfully upgraded our Cloudera Manager from 5.10.0 to 5.12.0. Okay, so we can check that 5.12.0. So now later we can upgrade this CDH also. Okay, so that I will be covering in a separate video. So thanks for watching. So please subscribe. Thank you. Bye.